subject English. Students, I hope you all will be fine.
So students, today we will start a new unit, unit number 8, The Young Writer.
So students, in this lesson, we will read about a writer who is very young in age. So let's start the reading. Huzaifa is in class 4. He is fond of reading and writing. He writes regularly for his school magazine. He has a large collection of storybooks and novels from the children's literature in his library. One day, Huzaifa was sitting in the living room in the evening waiting for a TV program to start. His father asked him, "What is on TV tonight?" Huzaifa told him, "There is going to be an interview in 10 minutes from now." "What is special about that interview?" his father asked. He replied, "This interview is with a young writer of our country." "That sounds interesting. I think I should join you to watch that program," he said curiously. "You are more than welcome," said Huzaifa. Soon the clock struck 9 and the program started. The audience was full of children. The host came in. Host: "Assalamu alaikum children. I'm Sania. Today our guest is a young writer of Pakistan who has just completed his new novel. Dear children, let's welcome our guest Faizan Aslam." Host: "Welcome to our show. How are you feeling?" Faizan: "I'm feeling really good to come to your show and get such a lively welcome from this wonderful audience." Host: "Well, share something about yourself." Faizan: "My name is Faizan Aslam Sufi. I am 11 years old and studying in 7th grade at Lahore Atchison College." Host: "So, when did you start dreaming to become a writer?" Faizan smilingly: "It happened 4 years ago. Once I was reading a newspaper when suddenly something came across my eyes. The youngest writer has one more novel to her credit.
I read
the whole feature. It was about a young girl in Korea who had her second book published on children's poetry. I was very much motivated after reading about her. That gave me courage and spirit to write. Moreover, my mother, who is a literature graduate, always encouraged me to write." Host: "That's really interesting. When was your first work published?" Faizan: "I wrote a number of short stories and poems, which were published in the Dawn magazine."
Host: "When was your first book haul published?" Faizan: "It was published in 2014 when I was 8 years old." Host: "Tell us something about your new novel, Instrumental Queens." Faizan: "This novel is the first of 5 successive novels named Chords Instruments. It is all about the world of imagination and fantasy. It has more than 40,000 words. There are interesting kinds of elements of fantasy introduced in this novel. This novel has been selected in the libraries of Harvard University, Columbia University, Princeton University, and many other famous universities." Host: "Mashallah, that's great. Did you ever imagine such fame and success?" Faizan: "It's like a dream come true. I was very determined to fulfill my ambition, and in this regard, I thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for helping me in every step." Host: "What are your goals for the future?" Faizan: "I am working on Instrumental Kings, the second part of Chords Instruments." Host: "Besides writing, what else do you do?" Faizan: "I play football on Sundays. I also spend time with my parents on weekends." Host: "Does your writing affect your studies?" Faizan: "Not at all. I give proper time to my studies. I manage all the things side by side. I never waste my time." host. We wish you all the very best for your future. Thank you so much for giving us your precious time. So this was our young writer Faizan Aslam. Let's have a round of applause for him. All the audience starts clapping. Faizan, that's my pleasure to be here. I thank you for inviting me. Huzaifa felt motivated after watching the interview. He turned off the TV and said, "Father, I want to become a storybook writer." "That's really good, my son. You have to work hard to fulfill your ambitions. I'm always here for you if you need any guidance or help," his father said. "Thank you so much, father," said Huzaifa. "Now go to sleep. It's getting late," his father said. So students, here we have completed our reading. Now we will come to our explanation of this unit. Dear students, I hope you will listen carefully. So this unit is all about a young boy who is a good writer of our country, and the special thing is that he is only 11 years old. As you read that his name was Faizan Aslam Sufi, who was a student of class 7 in Atchison College, Lahore. Dear students, Faizan was telling his story to the host of TV channel that when he was 7 years old, he was reading a newspaper and the newspaper changed his mind. So students, do you know what he read in newspaper? So students, here I am telling you that he read about a young Korean girl who wrote books on children's poetry. So Faizan got very much motivated by this news, and also his mother gave him courage to write. So students, the TV host was questioning him about himself, and he was telling her that he wrote many short stories and poems which were published in Dawn magazine. Faizan's first book, Haul, published in 2014 when he was only 8 years old. Dear students, TV host again asked about his new novel. Faizan told her that the new novel, Instrumental Queens, is the most successive novel from his top 5 novels named Chords Instruments. The novel was all about the world of imagination and consists on more than 40,000 words. This novel was selected in libraries of Harvard University, Columbia University, Princeton University, and many other universities. Dear students, the host again asked questions about his fame and success. Faizan replied that he had been decided to fulfill his desire and he thanked Allah for helping him. He told the TV host that he is working on novel Instrumental Kings, the second part of the Chords Instruments. The TV host questioned again, what does he do along with writing? Faizan answered that he plays football on Sundays and also spends his time with his parents on weekends. Faizan also told that he manages his all the things side by side and he never wastes his time. So here the TV program ended, and the viewer of this program, Huzaifa, got motivated by this program. Now Huzaifa turned off the TV and said to his father that he wants to become a storybook writer. Huzaifa's father encouraged his son for his goal. So dear students, we have found some new or difficult words. So let's come and discuss the meaning of those words. Now, your first word is novel. The meaning of novel is a work of fiction. Word number two is literature. The meaning of literature is pieces of writing that are valued as works of art, especially novels, plays, and poems. Word number three is waiting. The meaning of waiting is to delay movement. Number four, interview. The meaning of interview, an official face-to-face meeting. Number five, interesting. Interesting means arousing or holding the attention. Number 6. Curiously. The meaning of curiously is in a way that shows a strong desire to know about something. Number 7 is struck. Struck is the third form of strike, and the meaning of strike is to have a sharp or sudden effect. Number 8. Audience. The meaning of audience is a large gathering of people for hearing and watching. Number 9. Wonderful. Wonderful means surprising. Number 10. Across. Across means on the opposite side. Number 11. Credit. Credit means to bring honor upon. Number 12. Feature. Feature means one's structure. Number 13. Publish. Publish means to announce to the public. Number 14. Motivated. Motivated means enthusiastic about, striving toward a goal. Number 15. Courage. Courage means the quality of being confident. Number 16. Graduate. Graduate means a person who is recognized by a university. Number 17. Successive. Successive means coming one after the other in a series. Number 18. Imagination. Imagination means the act of mentally creating. Number 19. Fantasy. Fantasy means imaginary creatures. Number 20. Fame. Fame means the state of being known and talked by many people. Number 21. Determined. Determined means decided. Number 22. Fulfill. Fulfill means to obey. Number 23. Ambition. Ambition means something that you want to do or achieve. Number 24. Precious. Precious means high value or worth. Number 25 and the last is applause. Applause means the act of clapping. So dear students, here we have discussed our difficult words. I hope you will understand. Dear students, our unit has been completed here. I hope you all enjoyed this story. Thank you so much. Take care.